The man puts a bag over the toilet and shows the people how to defecate. He then pours in a shovelful of soil and packs the bag tightly so that it meets the standards before being thrown into the pit. In the aftermath of an apocalyptic disaster, the community demanded strict hygiene to prevent the spread of germs and disease. It turns out that South Korea was hit by a massive earthquake. Every building in the city collapsed. Only the palace neighborhood remained standing. Jack woke up stunned, and all he could do was count the supplies with his wife Lily. But to make matters worse, refugees began flooding into the neighborhood, knocking on doors in the middle of the night. Begging to be taken in, Jack wanted to refuse, but the kind Lily let them in. The next day, Jack gives 5,000 won to buy him food. But in this situation, money has lost its meaning. People can only barter to keep up with their needs. He had no choice but to return his expensive watch. When he got home, he winked at his wife, because he wanted to share such a precious tin with his wife alone. But before long, the foreigner pushed open the door, suggesting that her child was very hungry. The man was very unhappy in his heart. Gradually, the crowded environment was in turmoil. Some outsiders broke into the house and robbed it. Not only did they beat the native to death, but they also set the house on fire. An old man rushed out with a fire extinguisher and put out the fire like a hero. The women's director urgently called a meeting to discuss whether we should take in the foreign residents, but there were too many people to agree on that. Jack then proposed to elect a representative of the residents. Everyone looked at the man who put out the fire. His name is John. He lives in room 902. After a shy declaration, he leads the crowd to vote with black and white pieces. White to expel the outsiders. Black to keep the outsiders. The result of the vote was clear. The next day, John led a group of men in an eviction campaign. They blocked the outsiders from entering the flat with iron fences and shouted at them with loudspeakers. This immediately triggered resentment from the outsiders. They should be able to survive together. How can they let them live or die? The outsiders began to riot and tried to force their way into the building. The man hit the leader, John, with a blow to the head. This enraged John. He held them back with his own body. He shouted at them to get out. With John's bravery, the residents upstairs started throwing flower pots to keep the outsiders away. They finally worked together to disperse the outsiders. People began to cheer for John, and they praised the representative. Soon, the flat block was under systematic management. The men went out in groups to look for supplies. But it was during one of these trips, they were threatened at gunpoint by outsiders. Fortunately, Jack was able to sneak up behind them and save them. Whenever there was danger, John would always be at the front to protect the group, and so the Aborigines returned home with a full house. Life in the flat block is getting better and better, with plenty of supplies. On this day, the residents had a party to celebrate their success. But in the middle of it all, a girl walked in. She confirmed that she was the original resident of the building. Mary Ann lies in room 903. 903 is John's neighbor. John's face fell, but then he happily introduced Mary to everyone. Unknown to him, John was the real outsider. On the day of the disaster, he came to room 902 to collect his debt. But the man was a scoundrel. Angry John knocked the man to the ground. He lost control of himself and killed the man. At that moment, an unprecedented earthquake struck. In order to survive, John stayed in the palace neighborhood, disguised as the owner of room 902. His neighbor's presence makes him hesitant. John pretends to be delivering lamp oil, but he's actually threatening the girl. He threatens the girl to keep her mouth shut. The girl was so scared that she agreed, but then she told Lily about it. She said her next door neighbor was a creep, not John. Lily looked puzzled. Meanwhile, the outside world was becoming more chaotic. The neighborhood called the outsiders pests. The pests not only infested the neighborhood, they even killed the residents. But despite this, there are many kind-hearted natives who secretly provide them with food, including Jack's wife Lily. In order not to be evicted, Jack knelt down and asked for forgiveness from the representative. John asked him to work harder to protect everyone in the future. Jack had no choice but to agree. From that moment on, a manhunt was launched inside the apartment building. Anyone who had contact with the pests or took them in would be locked out and left to fend for themselves. Jack was very diligent in catching the pests to make up for his mistakes. They put the pests on public display. Just then, the earth's crust shook again and spewed out an endless stream of fresh water. People started to go home and fetch buckets of water. Lily and Mary, who have learned the truth, took advantage of the chaos to break through the wall and sneak into John's house. A freezer wrapped in tape aroused Lily's suspicion. When they opened the freezer, they saw a horrific body. On the other side, residents searching for supplies were attacked by pests. They killed another teenager. To protect the residents, John had to keep shooting at the pests. When they returned to the neighborhood in a state of disarray, the head of the women's department was devastated by the loss of her son. She blamed John for the death of her son and called him a murderer who didn't deserve to be a representative. At that moment, Lily shouts out the truth that John is an outsider. She took John's it out of her pocket and threw it on the ground, gesturing for everyone to see it. The residents carry out the freezer. Everyone learned the truth. They started attacking John, trying to get him out of the neighborhood. But just as the community was beginning to fall apart, a large number of outsiders invaded the neighborhood. People were beating each other up and running away. But no matter how hard they fought, the flat was already lost. With an explosion, order in and out of the neighborhood was disrupted. Jack, wounded, could only escape with his wife. The so-called pest also stepped over John's body. When he woke up the next day, Jack wasn't breathing either. Lily couldn't cry. What's worse than the end of the world is the loss of a loved one. Luckily, Lily was found by some homeless women. They asked Lily if she had anywhere to go and invited her to come with them. They found a house and started to settle in, generously handing Lily food. One of the men had heard that the people in the flat were always taking people to eat. Lily calmly says it's not true and that they're just ordinary people. This is the 2023 Korean sci-fi film Concrete Utopia. A massive earthquake has hit Korea and the city is collapsing like the end of the world. The only flat that didn't fall has become a utopia for refugees. Unresolved conflicts arise between the original residents and the outsiders. The ugliness of the human condition is evident in this apocalyptic world. This utopian neighborhood is full of metaphors and fantasies, and the more it tries to defend itself, the more it collapses. On the contrary, the goodness, caution, love and hope within the human nature are the eternal foundation that sustains human life. I'm Bulldog Movie. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, comment and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video.